And here now is the leader of the BBC Symphony Orchestra, Michael Davis. And seven soloists, the baritone Asghar Abdrasakov, who sings the bonds, the bass Neil Davis sings the chamberlain, baritone Jean-Luc Chenieux, the Emperor of China, and Hélène Perregin-Def. On the left-hand side of the rostrum is the Nightingale herself, the soprano Eva Malas-Godlewska, the cook, the mezzo Wendy Hoffman, and Wolfgang Bünten, the fisherman, who will hear first. A very warm welcome for Pierre Boulez to open this festival with The Nightingale by Stravinsky.
Oh! Thank you. mare pridasunt, a cala colcico.
Here we come. Keep on. Shala krvne ni shala mi am imperatora kitajska da.
Thank you. Я не хочу вас слушать, ах, музыки, сюда скорее музыки, музыки, больших китайских барабанов, ах, музыки.
Thank you. facti paius. Zacemu malcul spoies so. Ad dolei perului invetanu, ad des agnus mai noistu.
Signore, mi ero tra i gladi, e mi ero tra i gladi.
Fisherman's Song of Contentment, the Song of a New Dawn, the closing pages of The Nightingale by Igor Stravinsky, with the BBC Symphony Orchestra and Chorus, conducted by Pierre Boulez. Eva Malas-Godlewska is the coloratura who sang The Nightingale, Wendy Hoffman, the cook, Hélène Perrogin, Death, Wolfgang Bünchen, the very generous fisherman, what wonderful music that is, Jean-Luc Chenieux, the Emperor of China, and Asghar Abdrazzako, the Bonds. Neil Davis sung the Chamberlain. The three solo voices in Act Two were sung by members of the BBC Symphony Chorus, Susan Hampton, Anne Whelan, and Mark Denser, the Japanese envoys, Rory O'Connor, Paul Phoenix, and Christopher Foster, and the courtiers, the BBC Symphony Chorus, Chorus Master Stephen Jackson. Here they come. Several of these soloists took part in a staged version of the work in Paris recently, in which Boulez coupled The Nightingale with Schoenberg's Pierrot Lunaire, and according to Boulez, an absolutely marvellous performance from Christine Schaefer, Brian Bourne's recent Lulu. It's interesting, actually, that expressionism sort of reared its head in the shake of Pierrot Lunaire, because, of course, that piece, The Nightingale, somehow moves from the sensuous world of Debussy, even a touch of Mussorgsky, I think, to the Stravinsky of Petrushka, the Rite of Spring even, and perhaps Bartok and the expressionist world of Schoenberg to my ears towards the end. A journey which probably would not have been possible if, as I said earlier, Stravinsky hadn't interrupted the composition to write those great Diaghilev ballets. And of course, the conception of The Nightingale dates back to the period when Stravinsky was still studying with Rimsky-Korsakov. And the choice of the Hans Christian Andersen story was perhaps an endeavor to recapture childhood. In many ways, the work appears like, well, I suppose, a toy version of a full opera. After conducting it in Los Angeles in 59, Stravinsky said, "Perhaps The Nightingale only proves that I was right to compose ballets, since I was not yet ready for an opera." So I think he looked on The Nightingale as a story rather than a drama, the illumination.